Hello and welcome to the New Times News Review. We are going forward. We'll be taking a look at that one story that trended most throughout the week. And of course, invite one of our reporters to give us that in-depth view on that story. And at times also include the analysts to also share their point of view on that given story. Joining me today is Hudson Kutesa. He's one of our reporters. You're welcome, Hudson Kutesa.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, today we'll be discussing about this story that, of course, came out on Tuesday, where Rwanda, in partnership with the UNDP, that means the United Nations Development Programme, acquired three robots that are expected to help the country in responding to the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, Hudson, my question here is, what are we going to benefit from these three robots that we received recently?
One time in the early stages of the pandemic, the Minister of Health one time said that some people that got infected during this infection processes, and this is going to first protect the workers that have been working in these activities, and secondly, this is an investment. You know, Rwanda is going to use them even after the pandemic period, and also the work within this time of the pandemic is going to be easier, done easily, and also in a way that is not consuming a lot of time, but also with a lot of effectiveness.
Okay, still on that point, Hudson, you've of course told us how these robots will be effective as far as fighting COVID-19 in the country is concerned, but you also mentioned something related to these robots being effective or useful even after this pandemic. If you may highlight more on that.
I mean, that is quite obvious. A lot of the different equipment that have been bought during this pandemic period are going to be used even after the pandemic. But again, we also have to remember that maybe the COVID-19 pandemic has been a blessing in disguise, because you know what, a lot of investment has been put into the healthcare system. You can think about those 100 ventilators, or over 100 that have been, you know, secured by the country. They will even be working after the pandemic, so kind of a blessing in disguise, a lot of investment there.
Okay, thank you very much, Kutesa. I mean, it's obvious that when we are talking about COVID-19, we can't, I mean, talk about this issue and of course end without talking about the vaccination thing. We want to know, how far are we as a country towards acquiring these vaccines?
So, good question again. I think the COVID-19, the question of when the COVID-19 vaccine is coming into the country is one that everyone is asking themselves, because we look at it as a very important, you know, solution in dealing away with this, you know, crisis that has taken long due to the pandemic. If all goes well, according to the Ministry of Health, within this month, the first doses of the vaccine will be in the country. That is within 2 weeks from now. Rwanda will have started a vaccination campaign, and it will start with frontline workers, which includes healthcare workers and a number of other frontline workers that are working directly with activities that are related to controlling the virus.
Yeah, thank you very much, Kutesa. One can ask himself or herself, the 110,000 COVID-19 vaccines from COVAX, if I'm not mistaken, COVAX, and looking at the population of Rwanda, 12 million people, one can say that those are few. Beside COVAX framework, if you may also highlight about the numbers that we're expecting from COVAX, and besides that, do we have other channels that we're expected to, get the vaccine from?
Okay, so first of all, I should note that according to the targets of the Ministry of Health, they want to vaccinate 60% of all the Rwandan population, but that will be in the long run, like within 2 years. But within the short run, vaccines are getting available in phases, and this is the first phase. But according to the COVAX initiative, within the second quarter of this year, about 1 million vaccine doses from AstraZeneca will be also available in the country. But also Rwanda has secured other 2.6 million vaccine doses from the African Union initiative, also for availing vaccines to African countries. And if you look at this, I think this year will be kind of good. It will break the ground as far as this vaccination campaign is concerned, and we are positive.
Okay, thank you very much, Hudson Kutesa. This marks the end of this week's news review. I thank you very much, Hudson Kutesa, for being with us, and I hope next time you'll also, of course, allow to come and share your view on several issues that we'll be talking about by then. We also thank you very much for watching this week's news review. I am Lavi Mutanganchuro. See you next week.